Hello YouTube. So these are the charges I'm gonna test today. The first one was Blitzwolf. This one is Xiaomi power bank. This is Apple charger. It's for iPhone 5s. Yeah. The next one is the charger which came with Chinese tablet. This one is from my camera. And the last one is from Doogee phone. So because we are testing 5-volt charges, according to Ohm's law, we have to apply 2 ohms of resistance to draw 2.5 amps from the charger. I didn't have 2 ohm high power resistors. I had to solder some resistors in series. I will use this simple power meter, which displays voltage and current. First device tested is Xiaomi 10 amperes power bank. It's very popular. It has a lot of clones, as you can see in one of my videos where I pour some sand from cells extracted from fake power bank like this. So the Xiaomi says it will provide 2 amps at 5 volts. It gives over 2 amps. It is almost 10.5 amps, which is more than expected. Apple provides this charger with iPhone 5s. It is rated at 2.4 amps at 5.2 volts, which is about 12 watts of power. Voltage drop of 0.4 volts and 2.4 amps gives us about 11.5 watts, which is close enough. Chinese tablet charger. I didn't expect much from this. The build quality is really crappy. Quite high voltage at idle. But as you can see, the charger is quite capable. Voltage drop is minimal. It gives 2.6 amps, which is about 13.2 watts. It's really nice. This one is another Chinese charger. Build quality is probably the worst from all the chargers I am testing in this video. Quite high voltage at idle. And huge voltage drop to 3 volts, which is unacceptable. You probably won't charge a cell phone with it, a smartphone or a tablet. It probably won't even start charging. Very small charger from Doogee phone. It's very lightweight. It's the lightest from all the chargers I'm testing. Build quality is not bad. Plastic looks really cool. So we have exactly 5 volts at idle, and the display switches off. There is a diode in the display, so probably the voltage drop is too much for the diode to even start. Yeah, you can see it rises from 3 volts up, so probably voltage drop is below 3 volts. It's actually crap. The last charger for today. This one has 2 ports. This is why I had to build 2 rigs for testing the chargers. It's Blitzwolf, it's rated at double 2.4 amps. First I'm gonna test single port performance. It is 5.2 volts at idle. Voltage drop is quite significant, it's over half a volt, but the charger gives 2.4 amps as rated. So this needs some explaining. I didn't have 2 meters, 2 USB meters, so I had to use regular current meter. I connected the resistors in series with the meter. You can actually see current draw right now. It's 2.26 amps, and I'm connecting the second power meter, which draws almost 2.5 amps. So both ports are now at load. Voltage drop is minimal. First port gives 2.5 amps, the second one gives 2.35. So the power output matches the declared power output on the charger. And if you multiply current by voltage, you get almost exactly what the Blitzwolf says the charger delivers. There is one thing I have to mention though. All chargers connected to electricity outlet make high pitch noise. In one charger this noise is not bad. In the other, like Blitzwolf, when you use just one port, the high pitch noise is really annoying. The quietest of these chargers is the Apple charger. I will probably do another test where I just test the noise of the chargers. So thanks for watching, please subscribe and share the video. See you next time, bye.